We are looking at chapter number 2, Right and Duties in Indian Constitution. So question and answer on right and duties in Indian Constitution. Right, true or false against each of these statements. So a Bill of Right lays down the rights enjoyed by the people of country, and this is true. The Bill of Rights protects the liberties of individual, yes. Every country of the world has Bill of Rights, no. Why? Because you can say that 3/4 of the countries all over the world, they have democracy. They may have Bill of Rights, but those countries which are not in democracy, they might not have. The Constitution guarantees remedy against violation of rights. So this is also true. Which of the following is the best description of fundamental rights? The answer is the rights given and protected by the Constitution of the country. Read the following situation. Which fundamental right is being used or violated in each case and how? First is overweight male cabin crew. He is allowed to get promotion in the National Airlines, but their women colleagues who gained weight are penalized. Now this situation, a right of equality, gender bias is there. So right of equality is being violated on the ground of discrimination, whereas nobody should be discriminated under the right of equality on behalf of either caste, sex, religion, race or gender. A director makes a documentary film that criticizes the policies of the government. Now the director is expressing the abhivyakti, that is called the right of expression. So in the second situation, the right of freedom of speech and expression is being utilized, employed and used. People displaced by a big dam take out a rally demanding rehabilitation. So people displaced by a big dam, because the government has made, they take out rally demanding rehabilitation. So our constitution, though it grants right to reside and settle in any part of India in the right of freedom, but people have right to freedom of speech and expression also. In this case, the government can impose some restriction to maintain law and order, but those who are displaced, they can gather, they can rally, they can whatever government has decided, they can protest against what the government has taken decision. So this is the right of people. Peaceful protest is welcome in Indian Constitution. Andhra Society runs Telugu medium schools outside Andhra Pradesh. So this case is referring to the right of linguistic minorities to set up their own educational institute to preserve their culture, their heritage, their language. Therefore, the Andhra Pradesh can enjoy the right to run Telugu medium schools outside Andhra Pradesh also. Which of the following is correct interpretation of cultural and educational rights? So the answer is the C. Linguistic and religious minorities can open schools for their children and keep it reserved for them. So this statement is correct because we have Article 29 first and Article 30. This article says it protects the interest of minorities in India to preserve their own language, script and culture. And this Article 30 says it provides that all minorities shall have the right to establish and administer educational institutes, institution of their choice, because every minority or every group, they have certain culture, heritage, language, religion. So they have all the freedom to restrict them, to secure them and to propagate them. Which of the following is a violation of fundamental rights and why? So the answer is not paying minimum wages, because if you say 100 rupees we will give and you just give 20 or 40 rupees, this is a violation of fundamental rights and basically it's a exploitation violation. So not paying minimum wages is a violation of fundamental right. Why? Because this comes under the right against exploitation. Shoshan ke viruddha adhikar. बेगार फोर्स लेबर दैट इज द बंधुआ मजदूरी, बॉन्डेड लेबर दिस इज बॉन्डेड लेबर ऑफ बंधुआ मजदूरी, बेगार दैट इज नॉट गिविंग मनी फॉर वर्क, फोर्स लेबर दैट इज यूजिंग मसल पावर टू मेक पीपल वर्क एंड नॉट पेइंग मिनिमम वेजेस, दिस कम अंडर द राइट अगेंस्ट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन. ऑल्सो द खरीद फरोख्त, द सेलिंग एंड बाइंग ऑफ पीपल और लेबर एज स्लेव्स, दिस इज ऑल्सो प्रोहिबिटेड. सो इट हैज नाउ बीन डिक्लेयर्ड एज अ क्राइम एंड पनिशेबल ऑफेंस. An activist working among the poor says that the poor don't need fundamental rights. What they need are directive principles to be made legally binding. Do you agree with this? Give your reasons. So the most basic necessities of people are food, cloth, shelter. That is roti, kapda and makan. Hence we can say that the activist is partly correct. We are not saying that, you know, they don't need fundamental rights. They need fundamental rights. So he is partly correct in saying that the poor don't need fundamental right, they need something else. So the directive principle contain various non-justiciable rights on which the livelihood of poor depends, that is the right to adequate livelihood, equal pay for equal work, right against the economic exploitation and right to work. But we cannot ignore, we cannot say that the fundamental rights which are important to guarantee the right of life, employment and right against exploitation. So these fundamental rights are also required for anyone who is called the citizen of a country for a good living condition or to live happy. Several reports show that the caste groups previously associated with scavenging are forced to continue in this job. Those in position of authority refuse to give them any other job. Their children are discouraged from pursuing education. Which of their fundamental rights are being violated in this instance? So what we see here is right to freedom, first of all, culture and educational rights, and right to equality. All these are being violated. How? Right to freedom, under the situation given here, what we see here, the right of freedom of profession of an Indian citizen has been violated due to the forcing, forcefulness to continue in their jobs and to be refused the other jobs. So right to freedom is being violated. Cultural and educational rights, that is the cultural and educational rights are also violated due to the discouragement of their children from pursuing education, because every child has the right to get admission to any government or government-aided educational institute. The right to equality. The untouchability, chua-chut has also been abolished and everyone has the right to equal opportunities in employment, because all the citizens are equal before law, raja, rank, dono barabar hai. Hence, the right to equality is also violated. A petition by human rights group drew attention of the court to the condition of starvation and hunger in the country. Over 5 crore tons of food grains was stored in the godowns of the Food Corporation of India. Research show that the large number of ration card holders do not know about the quantity of food grains they can purchase from their fair price shop, that is the public distribution system. So it is requested the court to order the government to improve this PDS, public distribution system. So which different rights does this case involve? How are these rights interlinked? So if you see here, the right to equality, where everybody is equal before law and enjoys equal protection of law. So this case refers to a large number of ration and card who are holding the ration cards. They do not know about quality of food grains from ration shops. Also, the right against exploitation. Why? Because the ration shop owners exploit these ignorant people who are not having equal protection of law. Right to life, due to some of the people do not have knowledge about how much quantity they can get from the ration shops. So they may starve in want of food, or they may eat less food, so they will become kuposhit. Right to, that is malnutrition. Right to constitutional remedies is also involved, because the human rights group drew attention of the court to condition of starvation and hunger in the country. The second part is, should these rights form part of the right of life? So we can say yes, these rights should form the part of the right of life. Read the statement by Somnath Lahiri in the Constituent Assembly quoted in this discussion or chapter. Do you agree with him? If yes, give instances to prove it. if not give arguments against his position. So when you read, because it is given in your book, Somnath Lahiri's statement, so we agree with this Lahiri's view, because a police constable vigil over unlawful activities to maintain law and order in the society. Maximum fundamental rights work under the framework only, as if these are violated and requires remedial order by the court later on. So these rights do not include the right to adequate livelihood or equal pay for work, equal work, right to work, right against economic exploitation. So these are substantive to human life and should be incorporated in the fundamental rights of India. Like in South African Samvidhan constitution, the shelter and the health, also the environment, so you know, likely to live in a good environment, these are all included in the constitution. Which of the fundamental rights is, in your opinion, the most important right? Summarize its provision and give arguments to show why it is most important. So we have actually 6 fundamental rights. You can write it as 5 plus 1. Now these are the fundamental rights, and this fundamental right, the last one, is to execute or to safeguard these 5 the rights which we have. So the right to constitutional remedies, this is the last one, is considered as the heart of soul, as Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also said, of constitution. Why? Because a citizen can approach the Supreme Court or a High Court, direct Sarvoshch Nyayalaya, Uchcha Nyayalaya, you can go under this right in case of violation of any of these 5 fundamental rights. So the court can issue some special orders for the enforcement of these fundamental rights under the title of, we call this as writ. It can be habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, quo warranto, and certiorari. So under these mentioned writs, the fundamental rights are defendable. Now these are the NCERT questions we have taken. Now we'll take some extra questions, extra solved questions, along with some short and long questions that we'll take next time. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.